Hey, welcome back. Today we are going to cover another very important landmark judgment, that is the Lalita Kumari versus Government of UP, that is Uttar Pradesh 2013. It is regarding the registration of the FIR. So I will be telling you the facts, then we will come to the ratio. So let's first see the bench. Here the bench is Honorable Justice P. Sathashivam and Honorable Justice B.S. Chauhan. So further we see Honorable Justice Ranjana Prakash Desai, Honorable Justice Ranjan Gogoi and Honorable Justice S.A. Bobde. And the judgment was delivered by Honorable Justice P. Sathashivam. Okay. See, it is the five judges bench here, and I will come to the main important issue in the present case, because this is a landmark judgment, and let's talk about the first issue. So here we find that the issue is regarding the questions regarding the mandatory registration of the FIR. So we will see a list which is not an exhaustive list, but I will just show you those certain cases in which there can be delay. Obviously there is a requirement of preliminary inquiry, and but in certain cases, like the cases of kidnapping, rape, means if such offenses are there, obviously whenever the police officer or the officer in charge of the police station is receiving some information, and on its face it appears that yes, certain cognizable offense has been committed, so the FIR registration is mandatory. They cannot avoid their duty. Okay, so these are certain things which I will be talking about. So you issue is clear to you that whether the question is regarding the mandatory registration of the FIR. Okay, so let's see. First of all, I want to come to the facts, because the facts are briefly, just I'm telling you certain facts and then I will come to the ratio part. So the fact here is, there was a minor girl, obviously the Lalita Kumari in the present case, and she was kidnapped, and her father, Mr. Bhola Kamath, okay, so father went to the police station for the registration of the FIR, but maybe he, you know, at that point of time he was refused, so he filed the habeas corpus, and you know, it is the bulwark of the constitution, and to bring the body before the court, you can say. So it's a habeas corpus petition was filed before the Honorable Supreme Court of India, and I want to tell you that it is regarding, obviously, you know, when you file the writ of habeas corpus, when you go to the Honorable Supreme Court, then it is under Article 32 you used to go, and in the case of High Courts, you are supposed to go Honorable High Courts, then you are supposed to go under Article 226. So these two important facts. So on writs, I have already made the lecture, you can listen that, and the writs will be clear to you. So now I must proceed. So facts are that she was kidnapped, and the issue was regarding the registration of the FIR. So now the father contended that that even though he had submitted a written report to the officer in charge of the police station, but no action has been taken. Now if you want to make things very 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 clear, crystal clear, then if you have the Bare Act of the Criminal Procedure Code, then you please open it, the Bare Act 1973, CRPC 1973, and if you can read section 2O of the CRPC, which talks about the officer in charge of the police station, read with, you can read the section 36 at the same time, because they will tell you that any senior officer of the police station who is equivalent to the rank of the police officer in charge, so that you will be getting in section 36, and section 2O specifically defines the police officer in charge, and if he is absent, then the senior person next to his rank, means below his rank, obviously, so he will have to do that. So these things will be clear to you. Okay, Now we will see that that the FIR, so an FIR was filed only after the matter reached to the superintendent of the police. So FIR means earlier the FIR was not launched. So when the police filed the FIR, the FIR was lodged when the complaint, or you can say he made a written written complaint to the superintendent of police, because you directly don't go to the you have to exhaust all the remedies first. So the channel says you go to the the senior, you can say the senior station house officer first of all, and you please tell him that they are not filing an FIR. Or if yet your problem is not solved, then you can obviously go to the superintendent of the police, SP. So there you can also go. Commissioner, you can go, come to the commissioners, you can go. And if even though it fails, you can go to the judicial magistrates in the always there is a option available to you to exercise the writ option, that is you can go directly to the High Court, Honorable High Courts and the Supreme Court. So just I'm telling you the channel. So what happened, even despite telling the fact the police department did not file the FIR, did not actually lodged the FIR, and this is the reason father went to the SP and superintendent of police, and then finally the FIR was lodged. Now this is the simply fact, and quickly I'm talking about certain more sections. You please read section 154 of the CRPC, wherein the information in the cognizable cases. Okay, so police, you just read this. In the case of cognizable offenses, so without the warrant or magistrate orders, the police obviously can take the cognizance, and there is no requirement of the warrant, obviously, if you know. So you can read section 2C of the CRPC also, which talks about the cognizable offenses, and section 154, read that, and section 156 also, that is the police officer power to investigate the cognizable cases. So 156(3) ka bhi zikr hai, jo ki ek mein latest judgment, jo Veenu Bhai judgment hai, I will be talking about that, but in any other session I will be talking about the post cognizance order also, pre and post cognizance order. So that I will be doing it later on, but in the present case we will be talking about the Lalita Kumari case. And the 159, read 159 also, power to hold the preliminary inquiry by the magistrates also. So these sections, if you will read, then I think judgment will be then easier for you to understand. Now let's proceed. So the Honorable Supreme Court in this case framed a guideline to be followed by the police, the Honorable 5 judges bench ruled the following. Means certain guidelines were there, and I must tell you what are those guidelines. Now step by step, let's cover the very first guideline. First of all, I am talking about the first guideline. So registration of an FIR is mandatory under section 154 if information is received by the police regarding commission of a cognizable offense. So is it clear to you, cognizable offense? 2C mein it is defined in the CRPC, you just go and see. So whenever the information is received, obviously 154, this is actually chapter 12 of the CRPC, which is the executive chapter, that is regarding the police part, all the function, all the things which is to be done during the investigation. Chapter 12 is an executive chapter, that is a whole police work is given in this part. Okay, so they have to, this is written here, you just know, mark that they are writing the mandatory. So it is very important, please keep it in your mind, that if they are not registering your FIR in the case of cognizable offenses, then you can you must know this judgment, that it is mandatory, it is incumbent upon them to please to register the FIR. Obviously, so now I'm going to the second point. Second point says, see, no preliminary inquiry is permissible in such situation. So if something grave on the very face, you find that for example there is a rape case, or there is a anything which is you can say you find that yes, this is a very fit case for fit case to register, obviously, but just you are getting the information, you can understand what kind of situation, grave or grim situation it is, so obviously the FIR should be lodged in the case of the cognizable offenses. And no and they are also not saying that you preliminary inquiry is very important. It should be there. But if it is, you can under, and every a normal person can see that it is such a grave offense is here and such a very, you know, such a offense is there, which shocked the conscience. Obviously, don't wait for any other thing. Rather, first register the FIR and start doing other proceedings. Okay, now. The police officer, third I am reading, the police officer cannot avoid his duty of registering an offence, obviously the FIR they are talking about, the first information report, if the cognizable offence is disclosed. Now section, you can read IPC, you read section 40 of the IPC which talks about the offence, okay? So you can read also that also. Now let's come to the fourth point I am talking about. Action must be taken against the erring officers who do not register the FIR if information received by him discloses a cognizable offence. That means cognizable offence may they are bound, they are duty bound to register the FIR. So this is what the this judgment is, very important judgment. You must know this judgment. Now the fifth point I will be talking about. The court also provided an illustrative list of such cases which included matrimonial disputes, like family disputes, commercial dispute offence, medical negligence cases, corruption cases, cases where there was a delay in initiating the crime, criminal cases. So obviously these are certain cases you find that there may be certain delay. There may be certain delay, obviously, like you go and there is a family dispute, the commercial offense is there, medical negligence is there, so corruption matter is there. But even though the court is saying that in the case of cognizable offenses, you have to lodge the FIR. So this is the important point I am telling you. Okay, now I want to add the sixth another very important point, that the court, honorable court, also ordered that in any other case a preliminary inquiry should be initiated within 7 days. See, in the present case, so it was said that within 7 days the preliminary inquiry should be initiated, but later on it was modified in say 2014. Now they have increased the time limit, obviously, to right from 77 days to the 15 days. So at max 15 days, the you actually have to conduct the preliminary inquiry, or it should be initiated. So for 15 days time is also given, and normally and six weeks also might be 6 weeks. So you multiply 6 into 7, 7 6 are 42. So that means near about 42 days in exceptional cases they are talking about. Exceptional cases, normal cases may the 15 days, but in exceptional cases it may be 6 weeks. So this is the basically a very important judgment which I have covered, the Lalita Kumari case. And most important point which was we reached to the conclusion that in the case of cognizable offenses, the FIR should be lodged by the officer in charge of the police station. And this is regarding in the Lalita Kumari versus State of UP or the Government of Uttar Pradesh 2013 judgment. So I think sufficiently I have covered this judgment. I have also told you the provisions of the CRPC, even the IPC also. You just read all those. And please jot down the points. If you find things are important, please subscribe the channel also. And God bless to everyone.